सेवेंथ क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे विल डिस्कस पार्ट थर्ड, सोशल एंड पॉलिटिकल लाइफ, लेसन नंबर सेकंड, दैट इज हेल्थ केयर सर्विसेज इन इंडिया, पेज नंबर 222, पब्लिक हेल्थ सर्विसेज. Public health services, the backbone of healthcare services in India, are a string of dispensaries and hospitals run by the government in rural as well as urban areas. Their purpose is to provide quality health care services, either free or at low cost. It is called public primarily for two reasons. First, they are established to accomplish the place of providing superior health care services to all citizens. Second, the taxes that we pay are used for running these facilities. At the village level, we have small health centers with a trained nurse and a village health worker who deal with minor ailments. They work under the supervision of primary health center. The doctors at PHCs normally oversee the work of many villages. At the district level, district hospitals are there which have specific facilities for testing and treatment and watch over the functioning of health centers. In cities, there are large government hospitals. The treatment at these hospitals is cheap, but most of these hospitals have shortage of medicines, beds, equipment, and qualified staff. Besides, public health services are also responsible for organizing health camps in order to spread awareness about diseases like polio, hepatitis, malaria, chikungunya, jaundice, and tuberculosis. For example, certain Sundays are assigned as polio days on which children below the age of 5 are vaccinated against polio virus free of charge all over the country. Campaigns on sanitation and waste management are regularly planned in local languages by the government. As per our constitution, it is the prime obligation of the government to not only ensure the well-being of the people but also give essential health care services. It is a job of the government to preserve the right to life of every citizen and provide necessary health services. If hospitals fail to provide prompt and timely medical attention, it could cost someone's life. The neglect on part of the hospitals could have cost Munukunda Bala his life. Moreover, as discussed earlier, hospitals cannot turn away emergency patients. Medical personnel are bound to provide all forms of treatment in times of emergency. Private health services. Beside the public health services in rural areas, there are numerous private clinics, hospitals, and nursing homes that provide specialized health services. In rural areas, there are registered medical practitioners, RMPs, to treat patients. These days, many large corporations run hospitals, laboratories, and even undertake research and development in the field of medicines. Even private medicine shops are part of this system. Unlike the public health system, they are expensive and not within everyone's reach. Healthcare and equality. In the last few decades, we have seen a remarkable growth in private health services, especially in urban areas. As their prime objective is to earn profit, the cost of services is very high and it makes it out of bounds for the common people. Medicines have become so expensive that often illness in the family becomes a cause of worry. Doctors and hospitals too engage in unfair practices and encourage the most expensive treatment for the patients. For example, in the story you have read in this chapter, you noticed how for a simple case of diarrhea, Sirish was hospitalized, prescribed so many medicines and had to pay an inflated hospital's fees. In fact, only a very limited section of the society can afford medicines that one requires during illness, and it is also a cause of rural family debt in India. 40% of the population admitted in hospital for some ailment has to take a loan or put up for sale some possession to pay for the treatment. It causes suffering for even those who do not fall in the category of poor. Even though private health facilities are costly, a majority of the population prefer their services as they give better medical care and the surroundings is cleaner as compared to public health services. For the poor, it is major cause of worry and anguish. This is because due to poverty, they are malnourished, do not have access to the basic amenities, which is good food, clean drinking water, hygienic environment, and so they have the probability of falling sick more often. The cost incurred on sickness worsens their condition, and since it occurs frequently, the problems are compounded. In addition to lack of funds, there are other reasons that prevent people from getting appropriate medical attention. Women's health continues to be neglected in many parts of the country. They do not get prompt medical attention. In tribal belts, there are few health centers and they too do not function properly. There is a need to change the mindset of the people too. In rural areas, people still feel more comfortable in visiting village doctors rather than qualified medical practitioners. Healthcare remedy. Thus, it is quite apparent from the above discussion that the health situation in our country needs to be improved. For that, the government has to play a proactive role to provide essential health care facilities in the remote parts of the country. However, as mentioned earlier, health is also dependent upon hygienic surrounding, pollution-free environment, and clean drinking water. The Costa Rican approach. Let us read how Costa Rica, a country of South America, approached health issues, which become an example of every developing country. Long back, the government of this country decided to dismantle its army. The money spent on it was to be used on health, education, and other basic needs of the countries. Later, the government made and arrangement to provide basic services and amenities like safe drinking water, sanitation, nutrition and housing. Today they have been able to become one of the healthiest countries of South America.